Fresh Start fam, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today it is Wednesday, so it is our budget check-in day. We are going to review the bills that we had from July 10th to the 17th, which is today. We actually had a no spend day on the 10th, so woohoo, that's awesome. And then on the 11th, we went to Costco. And we spent $15. I know, we actually got out of there pretty good. My husband had heard about some markdowns that were happening, so he went up there and picked up a couple things that got marked down. There was a 4-pack of hand soaps that were marked down to like $3 each. So he got a couple of those, and then I think he got some Mongolian beef that was marked down. So he picked up just a few items, but a lot of bang for our buck on that. And then Walmart trip was $24. And then I spent $100 at our chiropractor. On Friday, I sent my husband back to Costco to get two more of the hand soap things, one for my sister and one for my mom. My husband went out with his buddies and got gyros for $20. And then I got gas at the Costco for $45. On Saturday, it was an absolutely lovely day. It was my one dog's 9th birthday, so we took her in the morning to Burger King, and I got my son a breakfast sandwich. I got myself a nice large black coffee, and then we got a breakfast sausage patty for my dog. That is her favorite treat. I'll post a picture of her eating it here. You can see by her eyes, she was excited about it. My husband loaded his work account at work, which is like... it's through the a vending company. It's a third-party vending company, but that way he could load a work account with some money and he can get things from the vending machine at work. So he loaded that with $10. Then, since we found out my husband was getting a raise and we had the 1,000 subscribers, we went out for a little celebration dinner and we spent a lot of money, at more than what we normally do, but the burger that we had at BJ's was absolutely phenomenal. It was phenomenal. And we tried, one of the reasons why we went here is because we tried to get this drink that's a bathtub, and it's a ceramic bathtub with a floating duck in it. And we thought when you buy the drink, you get to keep everything because that's what they said online. And then it turns out you don't get to keep it at all. Like originally the menu said, oh, for an extra $10. And we're like, okay, well, that sucks, but we're willing to pay the extra $10. And then the waiter said, no, you don't get to keep it at all because there's a nationwide shortage of the bathtubs. So Junior was a little upset he didn't get to keep the ceramic bathtub, but that's okay. It is what it is. We still had a lovely meal celebrating. And then we spent $71 at Costco buying some groceries, and we stopped by the gas station. This is marked as a grocery item because we didn't buy any gas there. We just got some beverages to enjoy while we were in the pool. And you could tell by the price what kind of beverages we got. It was of the grown-up variety. All right, Sunday the 14th, we went to the diner for breakfast, and then we took my dog to PetSmart and let her pick out a couple treats for her birthday. And then on Monday, back at Costco, we spent $12. I don't even remember what we got that day, to be honest with you. That's all right. And then my husband was off, so he did the Costco run, and he stopped by McDonald's and got himself some lunch for $8. And then on the 16th, they went out for ice cream. Today I had my chiropractor. I didn't pay anything while I was there, but my chiropractor is right next door to the Aldi, so I stopped over there and got some groceries. And the first half of our August mortgage came out, so we paid principal only the first pay period of mine in August. Today was the first, or I'm sorry, in July. July is a magic month for me, so I get 3 paychecks. The first one we paid principal only. This second pay period of July, I'm paying the first half of my August mortgage, and then the 31st I will pay the second half. So for the month of July, we are going to pay $1,650 towards our mortgage. Again, that includes a principal only payment as well. We have phone and internet of $338. Again, that includes, we're on a big family share plan, so it is my dad, my stepmom, both of their phone plans, plus they have a connected iPad, two of my sister's phone plans, one of my sister's watches, my phone plan, my husband's phone plan, my oldest son's phone plan, plus myself and my son have financed phones. And that is all for $338 a month. So I think that's pretty good. All right, our TV, music, and storage subscriptions cost $14 so far this month. Utilities, $316. You can see there are two utilities that have yet to happen, but because I get emails of, hey, when it comes up, this is what the bill's going to be, I was able to plan those out in advance. So $316 is what the utilities will be this month. We did a church donation of $25. That is after stuff church donations. We do other church donations that come right out of our, like an auto draft from our paycheck. So this is just after stuff, like if the church is doing anything special or any special fundraising. So groceries so far this month are $610. We budget typically $1,000 on a regular month. Because this is a magic month, it'll probably be $1,500, but I would like to still stay under $1,000 for the month. So hopefully we can. Dining and entertainment, we budget about $450 a month. We're only halfway through the month and we're already at $370. So we may go over in that category. But again, we know we spend more on dining and entertainment in the summertime because we kind of tend to hibernate in the wintertime. So if we go a little bit over that $450 mark, that's okay. Pets, we spent $43. Kids, we spent $100. Fuel, we are at $66. Health and beauty, it is $100 towards that chiropractor, and fun investments is $8. So total so far for this month, out of $6,650, we have spent $3,642. So we've either spent it or we plan on spending it because of the utilities that are coming out and then the mortgage that I know is going to come out. So that is what that is. But I also would like to give you guys a schedule update on things. These videos, so what I tend to do, and let me go to the next page and I'll show you guys. Okay. Let me make sure you guys are still in frame. Okay. So typically for the budget check-ins, I will do like this green week here going previously, and then I'll do the budget check-in on the last day of it. But it's hard because sometimes charges haven't posted yet. So like if we were to go out to a restaurant and then leave a tip, unless I jotted down, or if my husband went out with his friends and left a tip, I wouldn't exactly know the final amount because it hasn't posted yet. So it is a little difficult to do that. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do is I am going to do, so we have our game and saves on Tuesday. We still have our budget check-ins on Wednesday. Next week, there will be no budget check-in. You guys can see why. The video will still be called a budget check-in. However, it's kind of deceptive. It's kind of tricky. I want the giveaway to be for people that actually watch the videos. So today is the 17th. I am going to do the budget check-in for all charges happening between today, the 17th, through Sunday the 28th on the 31st. And then I think going 3 days between when I finalize those charges and when I do the budget check-in for it will, number one, allow any sort of final posting in my credit card or in my checking account of the balances or the charges. And then number two, it'll give me time to actually make the video and post it, because you guys can see it's 10:47 on Wednesday the 17th, but because I had to, you know, work today and then chiropractor and then grocery shopping, come home, cook dinner, log all of my budgeting and then add it to this calendar type of thing that I have here, that takes a lot of time. Plus then I was trying to give my kid a shower and get him to bed and spend a little bit of time with him and yet whatnot. So I just don't have time to do same day budget check-ins. So I think having it go from like Wednesday to Sunday and then doing the budget check-in 3 days later on Wednesday, that'll work out better. So there will be a video next Wednesday. It'll still be called budget check-in, but you guys know what it really is. That's a quick little sneak peek there for you. So then in August, the budget check-in, this one will be a longer budget check-in because it's going to go for multiple days since we have that going on. And then the Orange Week, the 29th through the 4th, that budget check-in will be Wednesday. And then those charges that are going on during this Purple Week, will the budget check-in for that will be this Wednesday. So this is how it'll go. So I'm still going to do the budget check-in, but it won't be charges from Wednesday to Wednesday, and then I'm doing that on that day. It'll be Wednesday to Sunday, and then the following Wednesday I do those check-ins for it. So I hope that makes sense. To me, when I'm planning things out, it seems to make a little bit more sense to me. I thought about eliminating the budget check-in day altogether or combining it with like 30 Thursday, because 30 Thursday and the budget check-in day both tend to be about a 10-minute, 15-minute video. And I figure combining them two, the videos will still be fairly short, but I could also kill two birds with one stone as far as getting you guys all the information. But I do think the budget check-ins are very important, as well as I think the 30 Thursday with the minis is also very important. And some people may not want to see both, so I do think I'm going to keep them on separate days, at least for right now. So again, there will be no budget check-in next week. You guys know why. Come back next week to check on the budget check-in video, even though that's not what it's really going to be. I'm going to still call it a budget check-in video. And then the actual budget check-in will take place 1 week after that. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And again, thank you so much to everybody who has joined the Fresh Start fam recently. I am so happy to have each and every one of you. And I look forward to making tons of videos that you guys like to see coming up in the next few months. I did hit my 1,000 subscriber threshold. However, I am at 2,500, about 2,500 on watch hours still. So watch hours, if you guys are looking to run playlists, I would greatly appreciate the help on that. So thank you guys so much for watching this budget check-in. Let me know how you guys are doing with your July budget. Is it a magic month for you as well? I'd really like to know about that. All right, guys, remember, every day is a fresh start towards building the life of your dreams. Have a good night. Bye-bye.